If you took the first path in this course, you'll now have an app that uses a machine learning model to filter for comment spam. You'll have coded a super simple app on Android or iOS to take text input, classify it, and then make a decision. If you're just starting at this point, don't worry, you can jump right in and the code labs have all the instructions. But what we'll do in this unit is learn how to update our existing model so that we can refine it for new circumstances. Well, what do I mean by this? Well, let's take a look. We started with a pretty simple app that didn't do any filtering of the import text at all. It simply allowed your users to send anything to your backend. Then we used TensorFlow-like Model Maker to build a machine learning model that could be used to filter text, which we then implemented in the app, and we provided a comment spam filter that prevented people from sending text that scored high on the comment spam ranking. So if they said something like make millions online and gave you the link to visit a website, it would be detected as a comment spam and ultimately rejected. Note that this is a very generic spam trained to recognize generic spam comments. And do note that the model you use in this tutorial is really just a toy model to teach you the principles. Don't use it in production. But what happens for specific spam comments that you face in your application that will actually get through this filter? So for example, I noticed that often spammers would bypass filters by deliberately misspelling words and not having a link. Their profile would then have a link to their spam site, so if you read the comment, well, there was a chance that you could also click on the link. So your challenge is now to update the model. The model was originally trained on data that we provided, but you'll probably want to enhance it with the data that you collect from your own site about how people have been putting comment spam in your content. And then together, this data can create a new model that you'll use in your app. So let's see it in action. So here's my app with the original model. If I type something like make money on the web and put in a link, it detects a very high probability of spam and it would filter out the message. But if I now try one of the messages that ended up on my site and wasn't detected as spam because of a misspelling and the link being in the user's profile, we can see that the general filter does not detect it as spam either. But if I retrain the model using data from my site that I flagged as spam and then redeploy it to my app and try again, I can now see that the same string is correctly identified as spam. In this unit, you'll learn how to enhance the base data set that the original model was trained on with your own data, and then you'll retrain the model to get the improved version. You'll add it into the app, and now you'll have improved spam filtering. So let's get coding.